This tutorial is part of our full-stack React Django DRF channels project, DJ Chat. You can watch this tutorial and many more from our YouTube course playlist, or the whole course, including access to additional resources from our Udemy course. The Udemy course link, which provides the best price for the course, is in the video description. Generally, when you're building an API and you're serving your front end on a different server to that of the backend API, generally you need to configure cross-origin resource sharing. CORS, or cross-origin resource sharing, is something that we don't necessarily need to know too much about when we're developing the application. But when we start to actually deploy the application and go through that process, that's really where it comes into its own, and we need a deeper understanding. So at the very minimum, we are going to need to configure the backend server, the backend API server, so that we can send requests from our front end, which is running on a different server. So without any information about CORS or why we need CORS and so on, let's just go ahead and actually configure our application first so that we can overcome the problem of having requests being sent from a different server to the backend, cross-origin resource sharing, so that the front-end server can actually successfully request data from our backend API. So here I'm making the assumption that you haven't seen the previous tutorial, because I did promote some who are familiar with installing Axios to skip that step. So if you haven't come from the previous tutorial, then let's just point out this basic piece of code here, which is going to send a request from the front end server to the back end to this particular URL to request all these servers related to a particular category. You don't need to do anything here. I'm just going to show you this example. So this is the common problem that you might find yourself having, and that is sending a request to the back end API server from your front end, and you're told that it has been blocked by the CORS policy. So no access control allowed origin header is present on the requested resource. So what's important to remember here is that this server is running on the localhost 5173 port. Now the backend API server here is running on the 127.0.0.1.8000 port, and this is why we're receiving this problem, because both servers are running on different domains or IP addresses or have different port numbers. Now to overcome that problem, really simply, all we need to do is in our Django application, so I'm just going to stop that server. In our Django application, we need to install the Django core headers. So pip install Django core headers. I've already done that, so give that a go. Once that's done, there are three steps. So first of all, you would need to go to the top here, and inside of your installed apps, you need to then add CORS headers. So that's the next step. So that's going to be inside of your installed apps. Once that's done, go down into the middleware and you need to add the core headers middleware. And that needs to be above the common middleware. That's important. So the CORS middleware needs to be hit first when the request comes into the Django environment. That needs to be hit first before the common middleware. So make sure that's above the common middleware. And then finally, what you need to do at the bottom here, we need to add a new section. That's going to be the CORS allows origins. And you can see what I've done here is I've added the server address, localhost 5173 of the React server. So that is going to then allow any requests from that origin. And that origin being where the React application is being sourced or hosted from. So with that in place, we can then go ahead and start the server again. If we go ahead now and I just refresh to run the code again, you can now see the request is successful and we're returning data from our API. So pretty much for the duration of this development, that's pretty much all you need to know about cross-origin resource sharing. The fact that if you are sending a request to your server, which is hosted on a different server, so in this case, our React application is being served from a different server, then you're going to need to set up your CORS headers to allow the, in this case, the React server location, which is localhost 5173. Needless to say, once you actually start to think about deploying this application, your IP address, your domain names are going to be slightly different. So you are going to be configuring CORS in a slightly different way based upon those different parameters. But like I said, you can just follow that short tutorial and you'll be good for the rest of this course, unless we specify any additional settings, which we will do once we start to work through security. We'll add some additional settings. For those who'd like to learn a little bit more about cross-origin resource sharing, I'm going to discuss a little bit more now. You don't have to listen to this now. Maybe come back a little bit later and listen to this. But you can see that I've opened up the browser. I've navigated to developer.mozilla.org and I've accessed the HTTP access control CORS resource here. This is a good introduction to learn a little bit about cross-origin resource sharing. I'm not going to read through this, but I'm going to give you some additional background information so that you can, or just to scaffold some knowledge so that you can go ahead and read through this in your own time. So this image here really depicts what it is that we've just set up. This first domaina.com web server, let's call that our React server, and the web server here, domainb.com, let's call that our Django server. So whether it be a domain name or an IP address, very much the same. The point here is that they've got different domain names, IP addresses, or port numbers. So generally what happens when we open the browser, navigate to our React application, is up at the top here, we send a request to the React web server, and then that then sends us back all the information regarding the setup of the application in our browser. We might go ahead and access more resources that are related to that page. So for example, images and CSS files, and that those requests might be sent across to our React server. And that's all on the same domain. So we're calling this same origin requests. So all the requests are coming or being sent to the same origin, which is our React application here on domaina.com. Now, as we've already seen, there may be occasions, for example, when we have set up an API or when we're retrieving data from different places, for example, images and maybe CSS files, other external files for our page, we may send requests to other servers to retrieve that data. So down the bottom here in this image, we have web server domainb.com. So that, like I said, in our scenario is our Django server, which is set up with a DRF API. And we're obviously sending a request to that server. Now, because we're sending a request from our web page, which is hosted and served from domaina.com, it means we're sending a request or a cross-origin request. So CORS cross-origin request to a different server. And this is why we needed to set up CORS. Right, so let's just talk a little bit about the same origin request. And this is what you want to learn about first, so the basic principles of same origin requests. So the primary purpose of this policy, the same origin request policy, is to prevent web pages from accessing resources on a different domain. That's what we've just emphasized here. So this happens to be incredibly important for keeping your browser experience secure. So by enforcing the same origin policy, web browsers ensure that web pages can't be accessed web pages can't access resources on other domains without authorization. So take, for example, imagine you log in to google.com and then you go to Amazon and you log into that. Now, behind the scenes in your browser, of course, it's storing information about those two websites. And that data might include sensitive information about logins and information about your username and so on. So what you don't want to have is, let's imagine, for example, web server B here had some script which could read other information about other websites that you visited. And that data is obviously stored in your browser. That could be incredibly dangerous to actually have that type of ability to do that. So the same origin policy is going to help protect information, for example, that's stored in your browser from accessing other information, other domain information that's stored in your browser. And that's going to help protect your, or like I said, is going to help prevent web pages from accessing resources on different domains. So to summarize the same origin policy, SOP, it has many different benefits when it comes to web security. So ultimately, it protects sensitive data. So the same origin policy ensures that web pages cannot access or manipulate data from other domains, preventing unauthorized access to sensitive information such as login credentials, cookies, and other personal data. So now knowing that the same origin policy is a browser security feature that restricts web pages from making requests to resources or accessing resources on different domains other than the web page that it was loading from, let's talk a little bit now about cross-origin resource sharing. So there are scenarios, like we've already seen in our project, where web applications might need to access resources on other domains, such as when it needs to retrieve data from an API hosted on a different server. So where a same origin policy protects accessing data on different domains, the cross-origin resource sharing policy is a security feature implemented in web browsers that allows web pages from one domain to make requests to resources on another domain. Now, how it does that is CORS adds a set of HTTP headers to the response from the server that tells the browser whether or not it should allow the web page to access the requested resource. So CORS utilizes headers. So CORS headers specify which domains are allowed to make requests to the server, which HTTP methods are allowed, which headers are allowed in the request, and whether or not credentials such as HTTP authentication or cookies can be sent in the request. If we go back to our example that we created, where we set up CORS or CORS headers in our application to allow the React application to send a request to our Django server, we configured the CORS allowed origins. So what we're doing here then, like I just said, is we're specifying which domains are allowed to make requests to the server. And you can see that we've set this up to allow the React domain or the React server to allow access to this server. Now, if you're not familiar with HTTP headers, HTTP headers are additional pieces of information that are sent along with a HTTP request or response between a client and server. So they essentially provide metadata about the request or response, such as the content type, caching directives, or authentication information. We can see from inspecting information from a request that we've made here from our server, from our React application, you can see here in the headers. So here I've gone into the Chrome console, selected networks, and then I've selected the request to the local host here. So you can see here that HTTP headers are structured as key value pairs. So what we're looking at here is the initial request to our React application. This is all the headers, all the HTTP headers, and all the additional metadata that's sent across. Now, if we scroll down here in this list, I can actually see the request we've sent to the Django server from this front end. So if I select that there, I can now see that I've made a request to the Django server, the DRF server, so our API server, and that was the category equals cat one. So we're returning all these servers related to a particular category. Now, if we have a look at some of this information here, you can see that the response headers, in the response, the access control allowed origin was actually included there. And that was the details that we set up in the server. And notice that the allowed access control allowed origin is the same as the React application domain. Let's see what happens when we turn this off. So when I turn off the setting that we created here, the CORS allowed origins in our server, we now retrieve an error. And if we look at the response headers from the server, it now suggests that the cross-origin opener policy has been set to same origin, which means that we can only send requests to our API server that resides on the same origin. In this case, the origin being the origin of the DRF server, which is 127.0.0.1:8000. At this point, I'll leave you to read the rest of this page, and as and when we need to know more information about CORS, we will slowly introduce that into the course. And like I said, we will need to drop back into CORS later on in this project when we start to implement security. So to summarize CORS, CORS enables web applications to access different resources on different domains while still enforcing the same origin policy security measures. The great thing about CORS is it provides a standard way to handle cross-origin requests, which does simplify the development process and reduces the likelihood of errors. One of the main benefits of utilizing this type of setup where you want to load resources from different origins, let's imagine, for example, you are serving your web page across the whole world. Of course, you want to try and localize where some resources are being served from, for example. So being able to serve resources from different servers can be important, for example, to enhance the user experience. So by enabling web applications to access resources on different domains, for example, CORS can improve the user experience by allowing web pages to load more quickly and potentially provide more interactive content. Hopefully that's given you a starting point to think about CORS if you want to explore that further. Otherwise, just configure your application as we specified at the start of this tutorial, and let's move on with the development.